Hi everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the settings of outlines. So before I discuss this issue, I would like to show you my web page on the right hand side and the HTML file that corresponds to this web page. So on the HTML file, I just have a heading, and after the heading, I have two paragraphs. And the first paragraph has an ID called ID1, and the second one has no ID. So let me go to the CSS file. So what is an outline? An outline is something placed outside the element. So it is very different from a similar concept called borders, and we are going to discuss the difference between the border and the outline in the course of our discussion. And the first important distinction is that individual outlines are not allowed to be set up. So an outline is simply regarded as an entity rather than four lines surrounding an element joined together. So how about setting an outline? Let me show you a way. So I would like to put an outline on the first paragraph. Okay, you can see that the outline is shown on the first paragraph with ID called ID1. An outline seems to be quite similar to a border, but we will see the differences later. And another difference between an outline and a border is that an outline does not count to the element size. So what does it mean by this idea? So let me give the width of the outline. Okay, when you see the outline right now, you're able to see that the width is quite thick as compared to the paragraph element size, okay? And you can also see that the outline width has nothing to do with the dimension of the element. So it means that the outline doesn't really count to the element dimensions. So we can treat outlines as something outside of the element. And we can also see that the outline is able to overlap other elements. So you can see that my second paragraph is overlapped by the outline coming from the first paragraph. Okay, so this is an important difference between an outline and a border. I can also set up the color for my outline. Okay, so we have set up the three basic components of an outline. In order to distinguish between the border and the outline, I would like to also set a border on this first paragraph. So a border is quite easy to set up. I just set up the border style first before I can do anything else. So you can see that the border style has changed. In order to visualize the style a bit easier, I would like to increase the width first. Okay, now the width is increased so that you're able to see the border a bit easier. Okay, now you can also see that the left border has changed its color to green. So I'm able to show you the difference between a border and an outline. We say that a border is included inside the element, while an outline is not included in the element. Okay, so it is treated as something outside the element. And we can also see that we cannot have a way to set part of the outlines to other settings. So an outline has to be treated as an entity as opposed to the border, in which you can set up the appearance of each of the borders. Okay. So if you want to give a better visual effect between the border and the outline, I can simply set up some separation between them. How can we do that? We have an attribute to do so. Okay, we can now see that the offset between the border and outline has increased to 20 pixels. So we can see that the outline coming from the first paragraph will try to cover more of my second paragraph, which is just below the first paragraph. Okay, so this idea can let us know that an outline is not counted as the element component. It is something outside the element. If you want to do the outline setup a bit easier, you can simply use the shorthand form, which is just combining all the three outline settings to one line. Okay, I'm simply changing the outline appearance of my second paragraph, and you can see that the outline has turned to a double style, and the outline width becomes 30 pixels, and the outline is pink in color. So you can also see that the second paragraph has an outline that overlaps the first paragraph, which is just above it. Okay, so we can use three values on the outline attribute to do the setup on just one line. Okay, so this completes the discussion of the outline in this video. And when we look back to the CSS file, we are able to see that the outline can be changed by three main attributes, which are outline style, outline width, and outline color. And we have to notice that an outline is not equal to a border. And in order to do the separation between the outline and the border, we can simply set up an offset between the outline and the border. In addition to the previous setup, we are also able to do the shorthand form of the outline setup on just one line. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.